Okay, good afternoon everyone. Today, first abstract I'll be presenting is a randomized clinical trial on 7 days a week post-operative radiotherapy versus concurrent post-operative radiochemotherapy in locally advanced cancers of the oral cavity and oropharynx, written by Wozniak et al. So first the background, both the studies done by Bernier et al. And Cooper et al. Showed that combined chemoradiotherapy showed better locoregional control in post-operative patients of head and neck cancer, making combined chemoradiotherapy as the standard of treatment as compared to radiotherapy alone. So also a paper written by Suvinsky et al. Showed better locoregional control in patients who were continuously irradiated 7 days a week as compared to conventional fractionated patients in the head and neck subsites of oral cavity and oropharynx, making a need of further evaluation of these subsets. So the purpose of this study was to compare the outcome in 7 days a week post-operative radiotherapy versus post-operative concurrent radiochemotherapy in locally advanced cancers of the oral cavity and the oropharynx. The primary endpoint for this study was locoregional tumor control, and the secondary endpoint being overall survival, metastasis-free survival, second cancer-free survival, and acute and late reactions. So the trial had two arms. In the combined modality arm, 63 grays of total radiation therapy was given. In 1.8 grays per fraction was given for 5 days a week, making the overall treatment time to 7 weeks. And 3 weekly cisplatin, 80 to 100 mg per meter square, was given during the course of radiotherapy. And in the other arm, total of 63 grays was given, 1.8 gray per fraction, for continuous 7 days a week, making overall treatment time of 5 weeks, and there was no chemotherapy added in this arm. The eligibility criteria for this patient eligibility criteria was the patients after major surgery for squamous cell cancer of the oral cavity or oropharynx with high or intermediate risk of recurrence, potential to tolerate chemotherapy, and informed consent. Exclusion criteria being patients after reconstructive surgery with the use of free flaps. Risk assessment was done by a rank scale, which was given by Ang et al., which was given in the paper by Ang et al., which graded the patient based on the adverse features as low, medium to intermediate risk, with the median follow-up of 5.4 years and with an intent to treat analysis. So all the patients were randomized to both the arms, and were analyzed at a later stage. The limitation for this study was the trial had to be closed prematurely. Only after recruiting 111 patients, that is the 40% of the intended trial size, due to slowing accrual. Also, there was incomplete data regarding extracapsular extension. Also, there were long intervals between the surgery. There were long intervals for the adjuvant RT post surgery. So these tables show that both the subgroups had almost same subset of patients. So removing any confounding factor if present, all the characteristics were common. So results for this trial was, according to treatment compliance in the combined modality arm, 11% of the patients had to be reduced to the RT dose, which was